Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform eSports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games. Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage. And 3 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. Ucypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
What's up, guys? This is Varun and I am Aisha, and we just want to give a shout out to all you people who've been watching and supporting our 6 excellent teams and all our cyber athletes on Ucypher, India's only multi-platform, multi-gaming, multiplayer esports championship. We have finally narrowed down to our top 4 teams. We have the Yakshas at the first place, then the Marksmen, then the Sherdils, and lastly the Akramaks. Today is the first semi-final of Ucypher. The winner will get to go to the finals, and the loser will have to say goodbye to the trophy. You are about to witness the first team, Team Yakshas, go up against Team 4, the Akramaks.
Akramaks and Yakshas are meeting in this tournament for the third time. The first time, Akramaks took the game home. The second time, Yakshas got their sweet revenge back and settled the score. This is the third time. They are meeting again in the semi-finals.
In the case of a tie, the captains will be called for a toss. The winning captain will choose which multiplayer game will be played as a tiebreaker.
Also, to jazz things up, we have changed the order of the games. So first, we'll have Tekken 7, then we'll have CSGO, then Real Cricket 17, and last, Dota 2. Aisha, what time is it?
It's gaming time! Welcome to the first semi-final of Ucypher. You guys are going up against the Yakshas. Is possibly the day that you make history or the day that you guys go home?
Kuch bhi ho jaye, history banne wali hai.
I have to tell you, is there something you want to tell everybody back home who's watching you do this? This is your semi-finals and you might not make it, and hopefully you will.
Support karo. Dekhte raho Ucypher. Koi bhi jeete, koi bhi haare. Lekin esports aage badhna chahiye.
All right, yes. Well said. Welcome to the semi-finals. Wish you guys all the very best.
Let's go!
आपने जो भी कुछ बोला था in your round robin matches, वो सब कुछ पूरा हुआ है.
Yes.
Number one team. First team to cross 100 and the only team to cross 100.
Yeah!
You guys started as underdogs. कोई पहले सोच नहीं रहा था कि यक्षास इतनी ऊपर आ पाएगी. धीरे-धीरे करके you proved everybody that you have the strongest squad.
Yes.
And now you're here, number one team.
Number one.
Playing the number four team despite being the best CS.
CS squad. Yes.
They're still number four.
Yeah, because they only have the CS squad, and as you pointed out that our tough competition है, मुझे नहीं लगता है. CS में होगा. बाकी तीन गेम तो I think we can sweep them very easily. We should sweep them very easily.
Around Robin stage पे, you knew for a fact कि if you don't win today, कल एक और दिन है, you can probably win tomorrow. But अभी if you lose, you go back home. There's no second chance from now on.
हम लोग तो यही mentality से आए थे Ucypher में कि हम आए हैं तो सिर्फ जीतेंगे. अभी तक सब सही होते आ रहा है, according to plan चल रहा है. Semis भी हम लोग ने बहुत अच्छे से decide करके रखा है क्या होने वाला है क्या नहीं. So we are all prepared, all set for this. We are nervous, but we are confident as well.
Come on, let's go!
Yakshas!
Let's go!
Yakshas!
Welcome to the first semi-final in our Ucypher Championship. Today we have the Akramaks taking on the mighty Yakshas, the only team to have crossed the 100-point mark. Let's talk a little bit about Tekken 7, because we have Jaunty Tank.
Jaunty.
This guy has been all over this league. He's had incredible performances. And the only guy who's been able to shut him down is Hans from the Sherdils.
Afro Ninja has to come up with new variations. If he's going to use Kazumi, he has to come up with new Tiger teleportation move. If grapple attacks come from him, probably he can kind of counter Jaunty today.
All right, so what are we waiting for? Let's get the semi-finals on the road.
Players apne character select karenge.
हर राउंड में जिसका एचपी खत्म हो जाएगा वो राउंड हार जाएगा। हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की, और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर। लेट द बैटल बिगिन।
With me, I have Jaunty Time from Yakshas and Afro Ninja from Akramaks. Afro, how have you prepared for this game? Because I've heard some stories.
कल मैं पूरा दिन हंस के साथ प्रैक्टिस कर रहा था। अच्छा लगा, उसने मेरे को सब काउंटर सब बता दिया, और फिर उसके बाद मैंने प्रैक्टिस भी की है बहुत।
हंस ने आपको पूरी रात सिखाया?
हाँ, दिन भर।
दिन भर। तो बेसिकली वो आपका ओपोनेंट है, बट फिर भी इज टीचिंग यू। सो डू यू थिंक द ट्रेनिंग दैट ही हैज टेकन फ्रॉम हंस इज गोइंग टू कम टू यूज in any way?
Yeah, Shekhar is also a good learner, so I am pretty sure he might have learned, but I have pretty very great counters for that as well.
Prize.
Yeah.
Afro, aap kafi kuch bolte apne opponent ko jaane se pehle. Kuch bolna chahoge?
Aaj bas concentration se hatna nahi mujhe, isliye kuch bolunga.
Theek hai yaar, all the best.
Thank you.
Jaunty, any last words to him?
Best of luck. Expecting a great fight.
Come on teams, make some noise for your players here.
Hello and welcome back to Tekken 7. It's time for the match between the Akramaks and the Yakshas. On Akramaks we have Afro Ninja, and on Yakshas we have Jaunty Tank.
Round 1. Fight.
And the game begins, and a good block from Kazumi over there. She's blocking really well, reading the game quite well over here. And that lunging tiger over Katrina. Well, Katrina now taking some damage, but instantly replying back as well. With a good uppercut, she gives a nice damage at the low as well. Good blocks from both of the players. Now Kazumi going low on HP. The 7-hitter combo comes in, and that's a low hit is gonna knock her out.
Round 2. Fight.
And now maintaining that distance between each other, and still Katrina moving in with the 7-hitter combo again over Kazumi. Kazumi going low on her HP. And now she is already low on 50%, and the lunging tiger comes in to protect her. And again, a good combo move from Kazumi over here. And third time as well. Now Katrina low on her HP, and it's gonna be a knockout.
Round 3. Fight.
And maintaining that distance, a good hop towards the backside. And Kazumi now taking some serious damage from Katrina. And that lunging tiger from Kazumi, trying to maintain that distance from her. Both of them on equal HP. Now playing really smart, and there she goes face first onto the ground. And Kazumi not stopping over here, just a hit away. Kazumi over here from the knockout. Well, she pulls the rage out on time, but it won't connect, and that low hit from Katrina knocks her off.
Fight.
And the fight begins. That uppercut couldn't connect, and there she goes face first onto the ground again. Well, Katrina again with the same move, face first for Kazumi onto the ground. Well, she is low on HP, she hasn't hit a single damage to Katrina over here. Looks like this is gonna be a perfect one. So the Yakshas win match number 1 of best of 5, 3-1.
Fight.
And the fight begins with that lunging tiger over Katrina. Good block from her, she's reading the game quite well, and a good reversal move from Kazumi. Well, she tried to block but couldn't go for the low block. Now Katrina noticing that she's not blocking low, she is going in for the combo, but the rage art connects from Kazumi over here, and Katrina is gonna take some decent amount of damage from that rage art, and now she is on 50% of her HP. Good blocks from Kazumi, but not for long, as this move is gonna knock her out.
Round 2. Fight.
And again she starts with a lunging tiger, Kazumi's favorite move. Well, now quite aggressive gameplay from Katrina, going in for the 7-hitter combo again. And that knee to the face, a huge damage over Kazumi. Now Katrina also taking some damage from Kazumi over here. Well, Kazumi going low on HP, and she does have the rage art, and it's gonna be a whip punish. Katrina missing that move. Both of them on rage art, but that low hit is gonna connect and knock Kazumi out.
Round 3.
Now going backwards, maintaining that distance, and here it comes, a whip punish for Kazumi and a 7-hitter combo again. Now Katrina going in for the mid hits, and Kazumi replying back with a decent amount of damage to her. Both of them on equal HP right now, But Kazumi does have the Rage Heart on her. She is waiting for the perfect time, not going for that aggressive move, and Katrina is gonna knock her out.
Come back.
Yaksha has been match number 2-3-0.
Round 1.
Well, a good sidestep from Kazumi at the start of the round. Katrina with good blocks, and Kazumi as well reading the game really good. But now she goes in for the combo again, a 7-hitter coming in for Kazumi. Kazumi blocking it really well, trying to read the game. And now she is low on HP. She does have the Rage Art. A good trade-off from Katrina, and the last hit to the mid is gonna knock her out.
Round 2.
Well, a good hit towards the low. She is not blocking low. That is going to be a huge punish for her. Again, that lower hit. Good blocks towards the mid, but not towards the low. And the Tiger comes in. Well, good game from Kazumi. Looks like a comeback into the game, but Katrina was on the Rage Art. Well, there it does connect the Rage Art, and she's going to end the game with style.
Round 3.
Kazumi going in for the uppercut, but blocked from Katrina now. Again, she goes in for the combo. An amazing move. A good upper block from Kazumi right over there. And not blocking low again. She has to read the game perfectly. Well, she is going low on HP. And Katrina putting a lot of pressure over Kazumi right over here. Kazumi is low on HP. Has the Rage Art, but couldn't do anything. As Yakshas are going to end the game with a perfect. Yakshas win the game.
Demolition, man.
Thanks, man.
That last round was brutal.
Actually, I was well prepared for it. I thought he is playing very technically today. He was punishing my combos. Then I realized that combo market bhi matlab nahi hai. I need to take him out on basics because ek raat mein ab kitna success hai.
Captain.
Yes.
First match, and what a game to watch.
Jonty hamesha opening achhi de deta hai. Usse team mein vibe bhi sahi create ho jati hai. Aur bas abhi ye jeet rahe, abhi sab jeetne wale aaj.
You have got the first 3 points.
Yeah.
And all the best, team. All the best.
And now, our first 5-pointer game of our first semi-finals. The most popular, the most fun, the most competitive, and the deadliest first-person shooter game in the world. CSGO.
Is game mein do teams hoti hain. Ek terrorist team aur dusri counter-terrorist team. ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट में खेला जाएगा प्लेयर्स कौन सा मैप खेलेंगे ये एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है द एम ऑफ द टेररिस्ट टीम इज टू प्लांट द बॉम्ब एंड सिक्योर इट और किल ऑल द काउंटर टेररिस्ट द एम ऑफ द काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम इज टू आइदर डिफ्यूज द बॉम्ब और किल ऑल द टेररिस्ट इस मैच में 30 राउंड्स होंगे एंड द फर्स्ट टीम टू विन 16 राउंड्स इज द गेम विनर इन द केस ऑफ अ टाई द रिजल्ट विल बी डिसाइडेड विद अ रेस टू 4 विन्स
अब तक आप ही स्ट्रेटजी रूम्स देखते आ रहे हो इट्स टाइम आई गो चेक इट आउट माइसेल्फ सो फॉलो मी
अपना टेकन प्लेयर हार चुका है तो अपने को सच्ची में जीतने का बहुत जरूरत है नहीं तो मैच में कमबैक नहीं कर पाएंगे सिटी साइड सेटअप अपन जो हमेशा करते थे वो नहीं करेंगे बी रिटेक खेलूंगा मैं पूरा डिफेंसिव अगर वो लोग फेक भी किया ना तो ये लोग दोनों को सेटअप नहीं छोड़ने का
अगर फेक भी हुआ तो अपन एक दो तीन को तो मार के ही मर सकते
इसमें एडवांटेजेस क्या है
सिटी साइड हम लोग ने मैक्सिमम राउंड्स निकाले तो टी साइड हम लोग का बहुत स्ट्रांग है इजीली जीत जाएंगे
हाउ मच डज दिस मैप अलाउ यू टू शो योर स्किल्स
इट शोस वेरी मच cuz आई प्ले मिड
Okay, you play here.
This side,
okay.
Mid abuse हो गया, तो उन लोगों को एक free path मिल जाता है, B जाना है, A ही जाना है। तो मेरे इधर ही सबसे ज़्यादा action होता है, तो frags ज़्यादा हो।
And you'll be taking care of that.
Yeah.
And where will Kappa you be?
B side. Maximum time मैं defense पे खेलता हूँ, क्योंकि solo anchor करता हूँ side. ये badman rotate करते रहता है। तो उसके लिए side से खेलता हूँ। आज लेकिन हम लोग का plan कुछ अलग है।
सामने वाले को surprise करेंगे।
What could possibly come as a surprise for you guys?
हम लोग हारेंगे तो वो सरप्राइज रहेगा।
Okay guys, I'm gonna leave you to this. Good luck boys. These guys are still at it. This could possibly be the longest strategy room sesh for the Akramaks. Let's head over to Varun now and check up on the Yakshas.
Why did you choose this map?
Because we are the most comfortable in this map. हमारे पास सबसे ज़्यादा strategy इसी map में है. The map K cash.
So what's your plan in cash right now?
Cash mein knife jeetne ka tum log obviously T lenge. T mein hum log ka first pistol round hum log A pe fake karenge, fir B jayenge, fir A pe bomb plant karenge. It's a double fake. Do log smoke karenge, recall master and mantri. Wo log seedha bhag ke B jayenge. They're gonna smoke from behind.
Oh wow.
Ekdam piche se smoke karenge aur log seedha B bhagenge.
Okay.
To jaise hi main yahan pe jaake marta hu ya mar jata hu, whatever happens with me, samne walon ka call aana chalu ho jayega, B aa raha hai, A fake hai. Hame B par ek kill bhi mil gaya, hum round jeet gaye. Hame A par ek kill bhi mil gaya, hum round jeet gaye. That's the plan.
You guys sound very confident, but time's up. It's game time now.
Oh yes.
And show the Akramaks what Yakshas have.
Oh yes.
All the best.
Thanks.
All the best.
This is the map, Brito, and now let's see what do they choose. It's gonna be cash. Welcome back, everyone. It's time for Counter-Strike between the Yakshas and the Akramaks. The teams are now assembling towards the mid for a knife round, and the winner of the knife round will get to choose the side. The fight begins as Starboy getting the first frag on Badman away. Yaman goes in for the second one. Skadoosh with a good backstab on Kappa. The captain goes down. Now a 2v3 situation. It's looking good for the Akramaks now because SMX getting that frag, making the 2v2, and SMX goes down. Now it's gonna be a 1-on-2 situation, and Yakshas win the knife round. Badman towards the side, he gets the first shot on the player and he goes down. Impale coming in from the blue doors, he gets a frag on SMX. Now Mantri getting a frag but instantly traded over there by Kappa. The player is holding on to the side, and now Kappa struggling with his accuracy over there but still manages to get down Recoil Master. And Impale over here, Impale and Starboy have planted the bomb on the bombsite A, and he's going on through the smoke. Impale gets a frag and the second one as well, and the Yakshas win the first round. Looks like an aggressive push coming in towards the A bomb site, and SMX getting the first frag. Mithun for the second one, spraying through the smoke but couldn't do a huge damage over there. And Skadoosh goes down with a nice tap from Mithun, and Mantri getting a nice trade off while SMX pushing in towards the A warehouse. Still holding over here, gets a frag on Impale as well. Now it's all on Mantri, a 1-on-4 situation. Well, he is just holding over there on 8 HP with a speed of 50, just a single tap away. And Mithil is gonna shut him down. The Akramaks are playing really well and not making it easy for the Yakshas. So now let's jump into round number 7. Recoil Master going towards Mithil with his AWP and a good flick to Manan over there, and he goes down, making it a 4v5 situation. Impale going in through the smokes onto the side, he gets a frag. Mithil holding to a nice posy over there. They didn't check it, and Mantri is gonna pay with his life. Now it's gonna be a 4-on-3 instant. Impale holding towards the blue doors, gets a frag on Kappa. Now it's gonna be Mithil in a 1-on-2 situation. Both the players are low on HP. Well, he finds one, it's gonna be Skadoosh to go down. And now it's left a 1v1 situation. Mithil onto the side, he is defeating the C4. It was impossible for Impale to get on this side through that molly because he was low on HP, and Mithil winning the round for the team. Starboy aggressive, gets a kill towards the quads. SMX goes down but couldn't manage to get a second frag, and Mithil instantly trading him off. And Manan towards the mid gets a frag on Skadoosh, and Impale with an amazing op shot on Kappa. Now it's gonna be a 3v3 situation. Mantri is on the side planting the C4, and the players from the Akramaks are now making a rotation towards the bomb side. And what a shot from Impale over there. Mantri on the side gets one frag as well. Now it's gonna be Mithil.
Mera aur Mithil ka 1-on-1 tha, aur time around about 10 seconds baki the. Main usne fake diffuse ki try kiya. Main third second pe peek kiya aur maine usko maar diya.
Well, Mithil with a nice boost gets a frag, gets two frags through the smoke, and now he is low on HP, gets the third frag as well. Now making it a 4v2 situation for the Yakshas. And Recoil Master onto the side, a nice quick scope to SMX over there, making it a 2v3, and there it goes. An amazing headshot to him as he goes down, and the last frag is gonna be Skadoosh to go down by Kappa. So this is gonna be the last round of the first half. So 10-4 is the current scoreline. Well, Impale with a nice flick shot to Batman over there, and one more kill by his teammates Kadosh, making it a 3v5 situation. But Manan holding towards mid, he gets a frag. Now the C4 is getting planted on bomb side B, a 3v3 situation for both of the teams. And now Impale getting a nice shot over SMX, and Skadoosh erasing off Manan over there. Mithil left in a 1-on-3 situation. He has to with this round and has to go for it. Well, a good lead on the Akramaks for 10 points now. And Impale is gonna shut him down the last track. So 10-5 is gonna be the first half. Skadoosh now moves in with an amazing tap to Mithil, and nice shot by him. Manan going on to the side, gets one frag, and Batman gets Skadoosh as well. Well, there is still a player holding towards the quads. They didn't spot him. That was a mistake. And now he is gonna pay his life. And Recall Master over here towards the truck gets a frag, making it a 2v2 situation. Well, the bomb has been planted towards the default position. And what a single tap to Kappa over there. Batman left in a 1-on-2 situation. Well, he is getting sandwiched from both of the angles, but somehow he is managing to just stay alive. But Mantri is making it difficult for him, and now he is going down. So the Yakshas win the second half pistol round.
मुझे डर था कि वो लोग डीगल से आके मेरी टीम को मार सकते हैं. I was very scared. Even in that round, मैंने मिड पुश किया. स्मोक के बाजू में जाके बैठ गया. And look at the confidence Mithil had. Smoke ke through bhag kar bahar aa raha hai.
And Manan towards the A, a single tap to Star Boy. What an amazing shot, but couldn't check the posi at the right time. Impale is gonna shut him down. Skadoosh towards the highway gets a frag on Batman. And a single tap again to Kappa. The captain is down. So the Yakshas and the Akramaks are playing really well, but the Akramaks is making it difficult for the Yakshas to win this game. So let's jump into round number 22. Starboy holding towards mid gets a frag on Manan, and Mithil is gonna trade him off. Well, Impale with a nice frag on Mithil as well, and again a trade off towards the mid, making it a 3v3 situation. Recall Master onto the side gets an instant frag onto the player, and now Batman making it a 1-on-1 situation for him by erasing off Recall Master. Skadoosh slowly moving towards the highway, misses a shot. A huge mistake from him. Well, Batman planting the C4 at the end moment. Well, he couldn't manage, and that amazing shot from him. The Akramaks now are on match point. Kappa getting a kill towards mid through the smoke. Starboy erasing off Manan, an aggressive push from him. And Mithil over here gets a frag towards the vent room. A good 3v3 situation. Looks like the site is clear. But Mithil getting a frag onto the player. It's gonna be Mantri to go down. He's pushing aggressive through the smoke. Starboy didn't expect that. And now Impale coming from behind. He has to clutch this, otherwise they will lose this game. Now it's gonna be a 1-on-2 situation for him. He is now just struggling with his bullets. Well, SMX comes in from the vents and erases him off. And Akramaks win the game.
मेरे प्लेयर्स का नाम देख के वो लोग की दिए और खौफ तो वो लोग के दिल में भी है. वो लोग का वाइस कैप्टन आईजीएल कुछ नहीं सकते हम लोग का, और हमें पता था इसके लिए वो लोग डबल डिजिट तक भी नहीं पहुंच सकते हम लोग के सामने.
Akramaks in your favor, 16-8. This first 5-pointer game goes to you. You guys have won the first in the semi-finals. Itne margin se jeetna, despite all of the preparations that they had done, ye expect kiya tha?
Haan, wo log ne zyada practice kiya tha na.
To isliye.
Overthinking ka natija yehi hota hai.
Okay, Kappa, I'd also like to tell you that the top three fraggers in CSGO, in Ucypher, are from the Akramaks. We have Mithil F with 276, Manan is next, and then also SMX. I believe our experts think that Mithil F really outdid himself this time.
Haan, jab hi uska din rehta hai, tabhi wo kisi se rukta nahi hai. Sirf W dabata hai aur maarte maarte aage badhte rehta hai.
Well, it clearly worked for you guys.
CSGO mere favor wala game hai, Dota 2 uska favor wala game hai. To abhi dekhte hai, ek team game main jeeta hu, lekin ek solo game haar gaya hu. To abhi ka solo game main jeetunga aur
टीम गेम अगर वो जीत गया तो मजा आएगा टाई होने के बाद।
ओह माय गॉड एक्रेन, ऑल्दो योर टीम केम रियली प्रिपेयर्ड टुडे, आज कुछ हम अलग देखना चाहते थे, राइट? द एलिमेंट ऑफ सरप्राइज, डू यू थिंक इट वाज मिसिंग?
No, actually today it was the CT side was weak. Our CT side, the execution was not right, and of course Manan, Mithil, they are very strong at shooting and everything, so they did their job pretty well. And even my team tried, but it didn't happen. But it's okay, two other games to go, so I'm mentally prepared for those two games now.
The Akramaks are leading. They are at 5 points, and the Yakshas are at 3. This is the first semi-final in U Cypher, guys. Congratulations and all the very best.
Thank you. Good luck.
There are still 8 points to be taken, one in a single player game and one in a multiplayer game. Up next is Real Cricket 17.
ये एक batting only match है. हर player एक over face करेगा जिसमें उसे maximum runs बनाने होंगे. मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा। टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर।
With me I have Love SX and iBot. आज की क्या तैयारी है आपकी?
कुछ नहीं, आज मैं एकदम कूल माइंड से आया हूँ। जो होगा देखा जाएगा।
iBot,
मैं तो नौ मैच जीता हूँ, तो वही कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ आज भी आया कि आज भी जीतूंगा।
जैसे कि ये सेमीफाइनल है, मैं आपके लिए एक नया कॉइन लेके आया हूँ। शायद किसी की किस्मत चमक जाए, ये विक्ट्री आप दोनों के लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। यू गाइस ऑलरेडी नो दिस, जो आज ये मैच जीतेगा वो ग्रैंड फिनाले ऑफ यूसाइफर में जाएगा। रेडी?
या
कौन कॉल करेगा?
हेड्स।
हेड्स इट इज। बैटिंग?
फर्स्ट बैटिंग।
ऑल द बेस्ट सागर, ऑल द बेस्ट आईबॉट। One final time, we'll be seeing the teacher go up against the student. Let's find out who wins.
Hello and welcome back to Real Cricket 17 between the Akramaks and the Yakshas. First ball comes in, and that's a huge hit towards the boundary. It's a six. The second ball comes in, again a whack towards the boundary. It's directly in the audience. It's a six. The third ball, he misses it. The three balls, 12 runs. Fourth ball of the over. And that's a good shot, but it stops towards the boundary. And now let's see how many runs can he take. He makes 3 runs. 4 balls, 15 runs. Second last ball. And looks like it's directly out of the stadium. It's a six. This is the last ball of the over. And that's a huge hit in the audience. And it's a six. So Akramaks now need 28 runs to win this game. And that's a huge hit by Sagar Vyas. It's a six. Second ball comes in, and again a whack towards the boundary. It's a six again. So two balls, 12 runs. Third ball comes in, and that's an LBW. He is out. Fourth ball of the over, and he misses the shot. And that's a huge hit towards the boundary. It's a six. This is the last ball of the over. Again, a whack towards the boundary. It's directly in the audience. It's a six. So the Yakshas win the game.
History of U Cypher, मैं कभी किसी गेम के लिए इतना टेंस्ड नहीं हुआ। आपने एक बॉल मिस की, फिर आपने 3 रन बनाए। I was like, ये गेम तो आपके हाथ से गया। And then Sagar ne batting kiye, he missed two balls and you guys won. Congratulations!
Thanks.
Akrid, is your heart back in place? Is it normal now?
Yeah, it's a bit normal now, but when the match was going, this is the first time in U Cypher I felt nervous. आज तक मुझे यहाँ पे कभी इतना नर्वस नहीं फील हुआ मैं इतना कभी डरा नहीं हूँ जितना मैं आज डरा हूँ बट यार शुभम थैंक यू मेरे भाई
कांग्रेचुलेशंस आई बॉट कांग्रेचुलेशंस आक्रिस यक्षास यू आर वन स्टेप क्लोजर टू द ग्रैंड फिनाले राइट नाउ यू आर एट 6 एंड आक्रमक्स आर एट 5 आई एम सुपर टेंस राइट नाउ दिस लास्ट गेम विल बी द डिसाइडर
Welcome back to U Cypher, Naya Sport, Naya Superstars. We're bang in the middle of our first semi-finals between the Akramaks and the Yakshas. The Yakshas are leading with 6 points and just 1 point below are the Akramaks. Our teams are bouncing with energy. There's so much excitement happening here. The crowd is about to go berserk and there's so much nervous energy that the arena is going to blow up. But before that happens, let me just remind you that everything is going to boil down to our last multiplayer game, Dota 2.
To season one of Ucypher as the Akramaks on the Raiden face off versus the Yakshas on the dais. Straight off the bat, Butter rotates to the mid lane on the Slada. Ish Raiden blows here with Kiko, but he's got to be careful as Max TP's in on the disruptor. Kiko, he is dropping low, but he is baiting Butter closer and closer to that tier 1 tower. He pops the salve, turns around, drops the chains, and Butter might have tanked one too many tower hits. Max will find that last sort of attack and will find first blood.
Again in the mid lane, now the toss to start things off. The Flame Guard burning down the refraction on Appa here. This should be another quick clean kill for the Akramaks.
Top lane, Akrid, he's chasing. He wants Dream on the center. Butter looking to close the gap, does have the crush. Dream, he's in a bit of a pickle here. He's searching for the hoof stomp, but he's not finding the opportunity. And Akrid with the Desolate finds the kill.
9-4 now, 12 minutes in on the top lane. The toss will start things off. The hoof stomp to follow it up. Akrid with the Vanguard, though fairly tanky, isn't gonna die to just that. If he sticks around here a bit too long, he could go down again. The toss comes out once more, but there's no Hoofstorm to follow it up. Akrid trying to get into the trees, but gets glimpsed back here into the kinetic field. They're going for the kill, and with the toss, they'll get it again. Blue Frog scoring that one, and now they're looking for more. They've got the Avalanche connecting onto Punk. Punk's going to be the focus here. He will be brought down, and next they're focusing Appa. One more toss was there, but it doesn't quite secure the kill. Appa alive for now, but Kiko may not be so fortunate. A toss back, Appa with a refraction, manages to dodge some of that damage and stays alive once more. Now Dream could be in trouble himself. He's looking for a kill. Here comes a Remnant. He doesn't want to jump in just yet though. This could be a dangerous spot for him to enter once again. The tower will fall, and Yakshas, they're not happy with just that. They want to get this kill on Blue Frog.
Butter, just going to try and catch up in the farming department, but here comes Blue Frog. The toss is there with the Stampede, and the Avalanche will find that kill. Mid lane, Kiko's going in. He's got the Lifestealer inside of him. Quick Fisher coming out, but the pure damage from the Infest, more than enough to bring him down.
In the Rosh Pit now, they'll claim Aegis for Appa on that Templar Assassin. This could be an opportunity to get an objective, but they want to fight nonetheless. The Hoofstorm comes out on top of the toss. Punk is down. Appa's in trouble now. He's trying to man-fight his way through this. He has a secondary life available. It looks like he's going to end up giving up that Aegis, but he does bring down Dream alongside. Now they're waiting for him to respawn elsewhere. You've got Yakshas losing Akrid on that Spectre. Appa, while he did respawn, can't quite offer enough as Kiko goes forward and ends up getting himself a double kill.
Kalnayak, he's picked up his Blink Dagger 30 minutes in, and bottom lane, we find the Echo Slam and the Fisher. Will manage to bring down Max, but might pay with his own life as well. In the end, it's not a trade that the Yakshas would be pleased with, but here comes Appa. He's got the damage. Kiko with the chains keeps his distance. Blue Frog goes in for the toss, but this might be the death of him. And with the Frostbite from the Crystal Maiden, he'll end up falling. Kiko, he's hiding in the trees, but the Corrosive Haze giving vision, and Appa finds the kill with a meld hit.
Dream with the double damage, Rune Spectre with the Radiance, and a Manta Cell, a Cheese for good measure as well. They've gone in on Atrin, they've jumped him hard, they've glimpsed him back. He does get the Manta dodge though to get rid of the glimpse. This is some sick stuff coming up from Atrin. The follow-up is there. Butter comes in. The Sireblade's ripping them a new one as Kiko goes down first. They'll bring down Max next and make believe with a Rage TP. Unsuccessful, he ends up going down as well.
Butter goes in with the crush, but where's the follow-up? There's the Echo Slam. They are controlling the heroes on the side of Akramaks. They have bought down Blue Frog, who ends up buying back as well. Appa's here with his BKB. He's trying to work on make-believe. Acted pops the cheese, and Appa finds the kill on the Lifestealer. Kiko remnants out of their Butter control, and the Strike Storm will end up falling along with Khalnayak. Two sources of initiation from the Yakshas down, but they have forced buybacks. Kiko looking for the Crystal Maiden, searching for that kill. Punk ultimately will take down to the Flame Guard, but Appa searching for more himself. Him and Akrid have managed to survive, but here's Blue Frog. Tosses back. Appa tries to bring down Kiko, but will be denied by the Sleight of Fish. Then Max being chased here by the Spectre. This time, Akrid will not touch the glimpse, but he will close the gap, and with the Radiance, he'll find the kill.
41 minutes in, there's a whole bunch of heroes dead on the side of the Yakshas. Now they're coming back in for another bar at 44 minutes, going for the tier 3 at the middle lane. Appa stunned up again, Avalanche will follow it up. The Searing Chains will not connect, the Sleight of Fist does a fair bit of damage, but they're still going in. Butter jumps in, gets the crush off on just make believe. The tier 3 has fallen, and the base is now exposed. Yakshas need to try and make a quick clean escape here. They'll start off with the Hoof Stomp to hold Appa in position, but he's still alive for now and going back in for another bout. The Searing Chains once again connecting, the BKB coming out from Butter. They've gone in here. They want to get the kill on Dream, and with the Mail hit, they will secure that kill and they'll go back for the Barracks. Refresher off on Atrid rather. He's gonna pop it. Echo Slam completely whiffed there from Khalnayak. A messy team fight from the Yakshas, but they'll secure the Barracks nonetheless, and Akramaks are just left watching.
I mean, Kiko's been trying with the Sleight of Fish, but he's not getting too much done. Akrid chasing for Max. Khalnayak is here with the Enchant Totem. They'll find that kill. Appa really low, but make believe takes a whole bunch of damage from the Templar Assassin and ends up falling. Appa eyes on the prize, will secure the melee barracks. The Yakshas are moving for the finish. Kiko finds one kill onto Butter, takes away the Aegis from the Templar Assassin and has no choice but to man up. But this is not a fight he can win. Akrid on a mega kill streak, and Appa along with Punk and Akrid will chase for more. Blue Frog has the Ghost Scepter that's gonna bind time, but time isn't enough. The Yakshas have got up to him. They're saving him for the bitter end, and the GG well played is called. The Akramaks just outplayed and outclassed by the Yakshas here in Season 1 of U Cypher.
In any tournament, in any game, across the globe, the one thing you want is one hand on the trophy, preferably both. But you've become the first side now, Akrid, to put one step into the grand finale and have one foot firmly closer to that trophy.
Yes.
How proud are you as captain of this side?
This was the aim from the start of U Cypher. Ki season 1 hai, jeetna hai, finals jana hi hai. And that was our aim. Jaisa socha tha, wahi hua. Semi-finals hamara kafi smooth gaya. Aur hum log kafi aaram se hum finals mein aa chuke hai. So I'm very happy and proud.
You're the first team in the final.
Yes.
It puts you in a very commanding position.
Mm-hmm. It's very good because now we have to see the next semi-finals, which is between Marksman and Sherdil. So agar Marksman aayi, to it will be an easy finals for us. Kyunki, as I said before, Sherdil is the team to beat. Aur agar wo log aate hai, to kafi tough ho sakta hai.
You know, you said way back that the Sherdils were the team to beat, but then again, at that point, you had beaten the Sherdils. So,
yes.
I don't think there's really any team to beat apart from the Yakshas, but do you like having the underdog tag or do you want to be the favourites going in?
Initially, we were underdogs, but I guess we are favourites now, so it's in the bag.
Well, the favourites are through to the grand finale and Akrid is at the helm. This is a big win for the Yakshas.
With the Akramaks at 5 points and the Yakshas at 11, we have come to the end of the first semi-final at Ucypher. And we have our first finalist, the Yakshas. They fought brilliantly throughout the championship and it's only fitting that they reached so far. But where there is a winner, there is a loser. Akramaks, take heart because you fought valiantly. But in the end, it was just not enough.
Tomorrow we have a second semi-finals between the Marksmen and the Shades, and trust me on this, it's going to be a lot more intense, a lot more brutal. Also, stay tuned for a final of Ucypher Season 1, 4 days from now. We'll be seeing you guys tomorrow, same time, same place, only on Ucypher Nair Sports, Nair Superstars, a U Sports initiative. My name is Varun.
And I'm Aisha.
To Ucypher. आज का मैच सबके लिए इक्वली इम्पोर्टेंट है. हंस आज तक एक मैच नहीं हारा. वो उनकी टीम का लगता है कि कंफर्म थ्री पॉइंटर बन चुका है.
देखते हैं आज क्या होता है.
अरे बाल थोड़े आगे कर ले, शक्ल छुपा है.
आज का आपका मैच टाइम एंड हुआ, बड़ी सेमीज है. यहाँ पर चीजें ऐसे खत्म नहीं होती. वी विल हैव अ टॉस जहाँ से ये पता लगेगा कि आप नेक्स्ट गेम कौन से खेलोगे. बट द ट्विस्ट इज द नेक्स्ट गेम कैन ओनली बी अ मल्टीप्लेयर गेम.
कुछ नहीं पा रहा था, मतलब मैडम बेटे तू क्या ये लोग को बाली लेके जाएगा, अभी तेरी पाली जाने की भी औकात नहीं है.